So now how do you make sure that your goals are something that's actually useful?
Well, actually, it's very easy to write learning goals, but it's difficult to write good ones. And one of the reasons why is because you have to follow through on those learning goals. So you have to be able to create the activities and the structures that support students in meeting those learning goals, and that's pretty complicated to do. You have to think about, how is this activity going to support the form of learning that I want them to be developing? And that takes a lot of practice.
So it's worthwhile to write your objectives, but it's also worthwhile to write them well. I asked some instructors what they find difficult about writing good learning objectives.
So I have a couple of struggles when I'm trying to write my learning objectives. One of them is I have this tendency to just start creating a laundry list. I'm looking at old notes or my textbook, and I just start thinking, well, my objectives are, and then I'm just going through the text page by page. Mm-hmm. So all of a sudden, I'm not looking at the big picture. I'm getting a little bit too micro level. The other difficulty that I have with writing objectives is the first thing that I write down is students should understand X. Yeah. And I can't help myself because that is my objective. Is I want them to understand Newton's second law or whatever it is. So it's always a conscious struggle for me to restructure the objectives in a way that's operationally define that isn't just the student will understand topic.
I think that's a really common problem. I think every instructor I've ever worked with wants to use the word understand. Or even the kinds of goals too. So faculty tend to focus on the content rather than the skills. So they will often say sort of informally, it's important for me that students be able to design a hypothesis or interpret some experiments, but then when they go to thinking about their objectives, they write just content down. And so sometimes one has to encourage them to think about, well, actually, how can they work with that content if they don't have the skills? But they're always happy to put the skills in there, they just don't know how to do it sometimes.
It's also, I think, hard sometimes to write the learning objectives in a way that students can understand them before they get to that topic. So trying to really think hard about the words that we're using in the learning objectives and trying to not go too specific with jargon and details that are not really at the core of the concept.
So you want to make sure that your learning goals are something that will really guide your course. And that's sometimes hard to hit on the first try. So there is a process of revision.
There's a few different things I'd like to go back and consider after to sort of critique my set of goals. So have I written my goals from a really expert point of view? If I was a student, how would I view those goals? And maybe I need to do some rewriting to be able to make the language more student-friendly or the jargon more understandable. Also want to consider what are the steps by which a student would need to get to that goal? Do I need to write some topic-level objectives so that they can get to that? And after that, I would probably take my draft set of goals and pass it to a colleague or maybe a student that's working in my lab and see what they think. Does it reflect the course that they would expect? And what suggestions do they have? And then the final check is to write some formative and summative assessments aligned with those goals and see how the students do on them. And that will tell me where gaps might be in the way the goals were written, and even if there are some things that are left out. Or it might just show me that my students are performing the way I expected on those goals, which is a great thing to see.